In this video, we're going to use two methods to show that a given sequence converges to zero. So the sequence that's going to be in question here is going to be determined by negative 1 raised to the nth power multiplied by e to the negative n power divided by n. Okay, so first let's look at the numerator. Okay. The numerator is such that we have this, and if we plug in the n values and check what we're going to have, we're going to have negative 1 multiplied by e to the negative 1. And that is less than or equal to, well, let's put the absolute value in there, less than or equal to 1. Okay? Now I'm going to explain why we're going to use the why we're using the absolute value, okay, in a second. So when we use n is equal to 2, we will have 1 multiplied by e to the negative 2, and that is also less than or equal to 1. So in fact, as you increase the x, as n increases, this decreases, okay? So the reason why I'm using the absolute value is because, as you can see, the negative 1 raised to the nth power will make sure that you will have alternating signs. And alternating signs means that you will have positive result, you have negative result, positive, negative, but whichever result you have, the absolute value of that will always be less than or equal to 1. So, the absolute value of the given of the numerator that we're trying to investigate here will decrease as n increases. Okay, so there's no way that it will ever be greater than 1. So it will be less than or equal to 1 always. So what does that mean? It means that using the properties of absolute value inequalities, we will have a negative 1. That's going to be the lowest value, and that will be less than or equal to negative 1 to the nth power, e to the negative n, less than or equal to 1. Okay? So now, what do we need to do here in order to make it look like the original sequence provided? We can introduce the denominator, right? So we can have divide all three sides of the inequality by n, right? So we're going to have negative 1 over n is less than or equal to negative 1 to the nth power e to the negative n divided by n is less than or equal to 1 over n. So we're going to use a famous corollary that states that if the limit as n approaches infinity of the absolute value of a sequence an is equal to 0, then the limit as n approaches infinity of an will also be equal to 0. Okay? And we know that the limit as n approaches infinity of the absolute value of negative 1 over n is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity of 1 over n. That's the same thing, right? Because negative 1, the absolute value of negative 1 just turns to 1, as you should know, and n is not affected because n is positive always, right? And that is equal to 0. Okay? So that means that both of these boundaries here, negative 1 over n and 1 over n, the positive and negative boundaries for the sequence, both converge to 0. Okay? So according to the squeeze theorem, okay, the squeeze theorem says that if for some n, let's say Pn is less than or equal to An is less than or equal to Cn, and well, I should say for all n, not some n, but all n, and here we're gonna make n is greater than or equal to n subscript 0 for all, okay? So it says that for all n greater than or equal to n subscript 0, the given sequence has a constraint on both sides. Okay, so it has the highest value as the sequence C and the lowest value sequence B, and both sequence B and sequence C converge to 0, well, to any limit, so L, then An must converge to L as well. So in this situation now, since the limit as n approaches infinity of negative 1 over n is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity of 1 over n is equal to 0, then the limit as n approaches infinity of negative 1 to the nth power e to the negative n divided by n is equal to 0, 2. Okay? So this is one way. It's a theoretical way of proving that the given sequence converges to 0. Now there's a second way, and we're going to use it here. There's a second way to show that it indeed converges to 0. And it's the trick here is to divide this given sequence into two parts. We can have negative 1 raised to the nth power divided by n multiply the e to the negative n. Okay, so we're going to say let bn, well, I should say c and d, perhaps, well, d and e, okay, well, f and g. Okay, so let fn is equal to negative 1 n divided by n, and g subscript n equal to e to the negative n. Okay, then the famous theorem says that the product, okay, so first let's find the limit as n approaches infinity, as we have shown, of negative 1 n over n is equal to 0. We've already showed that below, right? And the limit as n approaches infinity of e to the negative n, as you should know, is 0 as well, right? Because if you substitute directly infinity for n here, you will get e to the negative infinity, and that will equal to 0. Okay, because e to the negative n, as the sequence gets smaller and smaller as n increases, so it's natural that someday it will sometime it will converge to 0. Right, so using the famous theorem now, it says that the limit as n approaches infinity of the product of these two sequences is equal to the product of their individual limits. Okay, so that means the limit of fn multiplied by the limit as n approaches infinity of gn. And that is equal to, as we have just found, the individual limits for both sequences separately, 0 times 0 which is equal to 0. Okay, so you have used two methods here, one of them more or less theoretical and the other one a straightforward method, to show that indeed this given sequence, which can be broken down into two sequences, does converge to 0 as n approaches infinity. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video.